Keeping our world running while decarbonizing energy that powers it is everybody's challenge. But what's food and this restaurant got to do with energy? Well, natural gas is used to make fertilizer. And without fertilizer, the world would struggle to feed itself. Shell worked with pioneering customers to unlock the value in more energy and less emissions.
Yara was founded 120 so years ago. We're based on a breakthrough innovation of how to get nitrogen out of the air and turn it into a fixed product that we could feed the plants. Today, that innovation feeds 4 billion people every year. But at the same time, it's a production process that results in significant emissions, and we need to deal with that. But let's not forget there are huge business opportunities connected to this. There are a lot of potential income as a result of that. In order to produce this product, we use natural gas and we produce CO2 as well. While we have made great progress in reducing that already, this is not something that any company can do alone. And that's why it's very helpful to work with a company like Shell that has decarbonization very high on the agenda and understand the needs that we have. I could mention one important project that we're working on right now, and that's carbon capture and storage. And that's the project we're doing together with the Northern Lights, is to capture that CO2, compress it, and then pump it down below the seabed for permanent storage. And these are the kinds of solutions the world needs now to address the emissions challenge. So the great thing when we work together with a company like Shell, that we put our collective minds together to think about solutions, is that we come with new and exciting projects, like a really cool one in Brazil, where we're working on using residue from sugarcane production to turn that into biogas that we in turn can then use for the production of ammonia and fertilizer. So it's really full circle where you use the residue from crop production to produce fertilizer that you then in turn feed back in order to make even more crops. The Paris Agreement is not a barrier to business, it's an enabler of business opportunities. With the products that we produce and how we produce them, we're then going to be able to tap into new value.